तो इसका फायदा क्या है और इसको हम यूज कैसे कर सकते हैं? तो इस प्रेजेंटेशन के दो पर्पस हैं, एक तो टू एक्वेंट यू विद व्हाट बेसिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स इज ऑल अबाउट एंड व्हाट टूल्स आर अवेलेबल फॉर यू टू यूज इन योर रिसर्च, एंड सेकेंड हाउ टू help your students who are doing research under you or who are, you know, somehow acquainted with you to understand what this statistics is and how they can use it in their dissertation and thesis. So it's a very, very small presentation, and the level that I have selected is only up to a certain extent that you as a researcher would be using in the current scenario and your students would be using in the current scenario, because this is a very, very vast subject and we have hundreds and thousands of tests that would be utilized in various conditions. But we are only focusing on just two small aspects so that it helps you as a researcher and it helps your student as a researcher to fulfill the objectives of dissertation. So what is our purpose? Our purpose is to answer the research questions and to help determine the trends and relationships among the variables. हर जब हम रिसर्च करते हैं तो उसके अंदर हमारे कोई ना कोई रिसर्च क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, या हम हाइपोथेसिस लेते हैं, या हमारे पास रिसर्च स्टेटमेंट्स होती हैं. उन रिसर्च स्टेटमेंट्स को वी वांट टू फाइंड आउट द सॉल्यूशन टू दोज प्रॉब्लम्स. सो हम स्टेटिस्टिक्स इसलिए करते हैं कि हम उन रिसर्च क्वेश्चंस को आंसर कर सकें और हम कोई भी ट्रेंड्स या रिलेशनशिप्स जो भी वेरिएबल्स के बीच में हैं उनको अंडरस्टैंड कर सकें. तो वेरिएबल्स हो गए आपके, जो वेरिएबल्स आपने अपनी स्टडी में लिए हैं जिनके बेसिस पे आप डेटा कलेक्ट कर रहे हैं, उनके बीच में किस तरह का रिलेशनशिप है या वो एक दूसरे के साथ किस तरह से रिलेट करते हैं. तो व्हेन वी वांट टू फाइंड आउट दीज काइंड ऑफ आंसर्स वी यूज स्टैटिस्टिक्स, एंड स्टैटिस्टिकल एनालिसिस गिव्स मीनिंग टू द मीनिंगलेस नंबर्स, देयर बाय ब्रीदिंग लाइफ इनटू अ लाइफलेस डेटा. राइट, सो मीनिंगलेस नंबर्स एंड लाइफलेस डेटा फोकस इज ऑन दिस. So say for example, if we have 5 numbers, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Now, do these numbers have any meaning as such? No, nothing. So these numbers will only have meaning if we say, okay, what is the mean of these numbers? Or if we say, what is the median of these numbers? Or what is the standard deviation of this number? So unless and until we have a meaning to this lifeless data, then only that data is of any importance to us. So in order to bring meaning to numbers, we use statistics, and results and inferences are precise only if proper statistical tests are used. कोई भी आप अगर चीज बड़े confidence से अपनी thesis में कहते हैं या अपनी research paper में कहते हैं तो उसका basis कुछ तो होगा. वो basis क्या है? Statistics. So unless we have those results, we will not be able to, you know, give precise inferences in our thesis. So these are three important purposes of statistical techniques, why we need to use them. Next, sir. So then steps in data analysis. What are the steps that all of us need to, you know, adhere to when we are doing data analysis? So I have divided them into two categories. One is before data collection, one is after data collection. So before data collection, we need to determine the methods of data analysis. We need to determine how to process the data. We need to consult a statistician if we are not aware about statistics, right? And we also need to prepare dummy tables, how the data is would be required. So amuman kya hota hai ki jab hamare students SPSS karte hain aur ek F test karte hain, to uska 4 page ka itna lamba table jo hai wo SPS nikal deta hai. तो उस टाइम वो बच्चा जो है वो कंफ्यूज हो जाता है कि अब मैं कौन सा डेटा इसमें से उठा के अपने टेबल में डालूं. सो इसलिए ये सब चीजें अगर हमारी पहले से प्लान्ड होगी तो उस डेटा को इंटरप्रेट करना और वहां से सिर्फ मीनिंगफुल इंफॉर्मेशन निकालना हमारे लिए आसान हो जाएगा. सो वी नीड टू डिटरमिन कि व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी द मेथड, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोसेस द डेटा, एंड वी नीड टू कंसल्ट अ स्टैटिस्टिशियन एंड प्रिपेयर डमी टेबल्स. देन इज द सेकंड स्टेप व्हिच इज आफ्टर डेटा कलेक्शन. So after data collection, we need to process the data. We need to prepare the tables and graphs. And we need to analyze and interpret our findings. Consult again the statistician that whatever the tools that you have used, whether they have given an adequate result or that result can be adequately interpreted, whether the data is meaningful enough so that you can analyze your results. And then you need to prepare your results according to your objectives or your research statements, whatever you have constituted in your research thesis. So you need to process the data, you need to prepare the tables and graphs, because just giving numbers also is of no value unless and until they are produced in a proper table and they are adequately graphically represented. For example, if you are comparing two groups, so what kind of a graph would you make to show that there is a difference in the two groups, right? So it is these kind of questions that lead us to what kind of statistical techniques that we require. Sir, next. So we are only talking about two types of data analysis which are we are all should be concerned about and our students should be concerned about. One is descriptive statistics and one is inferential statistics, right? Only these two. So what is descriptive statistics? So descriptive statistics is basically use of numerical information to summarize, simplify and present masses of data. Masses of data is, for example, your students collect data from 300 students. Now how that data would be represented? Unless and until we don't use a descriptive statistical technique to analyze that kind of data. So we, in order to give numerical use of numerical information to summarize, then it refers to the description of the data from a particular sample. It is organized and summarized for clearer presentation and for ease of communication of results. Mean sabko samajh aata hai, median sabko samajh aata hai, mode sabko samajh aata hai. So for ease of communication of results. And then data may come from studies of population, which could be, you know, often called as census studies or samples. So usually descriptive data works on population and samples. So now we come to the different types of statistical tools that you would be requiring. Next, sir. So how are we going to present data? One is graphical representation. So if we have graphical representation, what would that mean? What kind of graphs are we actually using? Have you used any graphs before? Graphical representation.
Bar graphs, histograms,
pie charts.
Anything else? Any curves?
Frequency,
polygon is one. Any curve? Ogive, right? Which is basically a, what is an ogive?
Cumulative
frequency percentage curve, right? So there are various ways of representing data. Similarly, arranging data in tables and bar graphs and pie charts. So we have one kind